Hello everyone, welcome to Nitsia channel. So this is the part 2 of broadcasting design promo in Cinema 4D. And this part 2 we are going to talk about the motion. So in motion here we are going to animate text and also animate the camera. So in this scene we are going to animate the text first, and after that we will animate the camera by using mob camera. And this is the nav part that contains the text and the text box. So we are going to put it in fracture. We go to mold graph and fracture. And here I rename text. After that, I drag all the elements in here, put it into the fracture that we just created. Now it's not necessary anymore, so I delete it. And in text here, if we go to transform and if we rotate it, now you can see it rotate it properly, not any error. So you can use effector to animate it. Or if you don't want to animate, you can just animate it with keyframe of rotation of the fracture. For example, if I animate like that, and I add another keyframe, now you see it have animating on rotation. I don't want to animate in this technique, so I delete it. Now before we animate, let's increase the timeline here to 125 frames. It means 5 seconds. And I select text, go to mold graph, effector and plane. If we go to the text fracture, now you can see in the effector tab, the plane effector is in it. And we go to plane in parameter. We not animate in position, so we uncheck it. And I will play around with rotation. I will animate in rotation RH. In 0 frame, I will make it 90 degrees like that. And far off here, I use, there are a lot of fear that you can play around, but in here I will use linear fear. And then I move around the position of the fear to put it fit with the text. You can scale it like that. In linear fear, you can scale it while in the fill and length, and you can play around with the length to see how it affects to the text. And if I move it to the left, as you can see, so I will put something around that and I scale it a little bit, maybe around 150 centimeters. So we are going to keyframe the position of X coordinate in linear fear. So before we keyframe, you need to find how your text look like by moving the linear fear like that. And after you satisfy with the position and how your text look like, we just add a keyframe on it. So in here, in this position, in 0 frame, I add one keyframe in X position of linear fear, and then maybe around frame 25, I move the X position of linear fear to the right side like that. So it will become OS Computers. Let's move the keyframe to frame 25. Okay. Now let's see the preview. Okay, now we got some animation like that. So you have to remember what we animate in the linear of the plan. We not animate in plan position anymore, okay? And the motion is not smooth yet, so I need to use another effector, is effector delay. And in effector delay, we can check here now. Effector delay is in our fracture, and we come back to effector delay, and we not play around with the fall off. But in effector tab, we use mode blend, but we increase the strength to 60%. So now it's become smoother. Okay, so that's all for animate the text. It's just simple with using MoGraph effector plan and delay, and we animate keyframe with the fall off linear. Now we are going to animate the camera by using mob camera. Let's start from sketch. So I create new camera, and this is camera one, and then I change focal length to wide angle 25 mm, and let's find the position that make the scene more interesting. So I zoom in, and in zero frame let's find the, you can turn on the composition helper to see how it look like. Now I use grid composition, and let's change color to make it easier looking. So I start from something perspective like that. Rotate it in RV. You don't have to play around with the perspective of camera the same me. Just find what perspective of camera that certify for you. So now I like this angle, and then I create camera 2. Let's copy from camera 1 and I rename it to camera 2, and then turn it on. And camera 2, I not rotate anything and zoom it out a little bit, something like that. And then I create another camera. This is camera 3. And I turn it on. So camera 3 is the final camera. So I zoom it out so far like that. So this is camera 1, camera 2, and camera 3. So the motion is we start from camera 1 to camera 2 and camera 3. So we are going to mob it. Let's select all the camera and go to create camera and camera mob. So let's turn on mob camera and click on the icon in of mob camera here, and go to camera mob tab. So we use interpolation of slot 1. So if we increase it to 100%, you can see it will go to camera 1. So we are going to add a keyframe in blend 100%. in 0 frame. So in 0 frame, and we add 1 keyframe. And after that, we move a timeline of keyframe a little bit around frame 25, something like that, and add another keyframe. Now let's see the motion. It will look like that. And until frame 125, we increase it to 0% to make it move to camera 3. So let's see the motion of camera mob. It will looking like that. So the motion is the motion of mob camera that mob from camera 1 to camera 3. Okay. So let's see the preview how the motion look like by going to this icon and make preview. Choose all frame and OK. So it will calculating the preview. So now we got it and let's see how it look. So if you not satisfied with any motion of the camera, you still can adjust it by go to adjust it of each individual of camera. So I think the motion is fine. So this is that's all for part 2 of broadcasting design promo. They're talking about motion. We animate the text and animate the camera mode. So see you in the next video of part 3 that we will talk about lighting in this scene. Thank you very much for watching. Good luck and stay home, stay safe.